Okay, welcome everybody to the very first episode of the
very first
Rhinos and Aliens show.
Bruno.
My name is Francis Mondrala.
This is Michael Dabney,
and I'm Jordan Snyateki.
We were thinking for quite a long time what would be a good topic for the very first episode, and we just randomly came along those awkward, random boners you get in public.
I don't know what he's talking about. I don't know what he's talking about, guys.
Okay, so how do you want to start this?
First of all, man, when we talk about this, we got to embrace the fact that this is one of the most awkward moments for a guy. Depending on where he is, actually.
Yes, depending on where he is, it can be very awkward.
Is it awkward because the person thinks it's awkward or because of society?
Well, I'm assuming the person thinks it's awkward because of the society he was born into. So okay. It'll be awkward for both. You understand what I'm saying?
I agree. Like, the first thing that I think about when I got a random stiffy, man.
Gotcha.
I'm thinking like, damn.
Uh-huh.
There's kids and old people around here, man.
Dude, kids
they can't be seeing stuff like that, man. It's just...
Was it bad? Was it real bad?
What do you mean?
Like the situation. Was it real bad? Like, oh, was it you could not hide it?
It's been multiple times where
multiple
it's been like
times.
That.
Okay. Okay. Multiple times.
Like, lately, I've just been saying, fuck it. Like, if you see my love rod, man, it's just going to poke through, bitch.
Nah, man. You gotta hold that love rod down. You got to make him know not time.
I think that would take Hoover Dam to do that, man.
Bro, you don't need that. That's just too much stress in your life. Way too much stress. I can't do it.
Random boners, huh?
Uh-huh. Elaborate, Francis. Tell me more.
All right, what's your experience?
Tell me more, bro. This is great.
Okay, well, I believe there's two levels.
Two levels,
it's the horniness that leads to the boner.
Gotcha.
And then the actual boner itself.
Okay.
You feel me?
Kind of.
Okay, so, for example... Okay, when you see that woman, or you see whatever...
Okay, there we go.
That turns you on.
Can't assume genders.
Right?
Yeah. Gotcha.
You get that feeling. It's like a buildup, right?
Okay.
That is coming.
Yeah, because you automatically know when you're going to have one.
Yes.
Okay, I got you.
So you could do one of two things.
Uh-huh.
You could prepare for it or say, you know what? I'm just going to go with the flow.
Okay, real quick.
Okay.
How do you prepare for it?
I don't know.
What do you mean? Have you never prepared?
Okay, when I say prepare,
okay.
You know, it's okay, for example, you see death coming, right?
Okay.
How can you really prepare for it? You just know it's coming.
You accept it.
Yes.
Okay.
So
when you say prepare, you don't mean prepare. You mean, well, you do mean prepare.
You brace yourself,
but you don't mean prepare
basically.
To stop it. You mean prepare to let it happen.
Yes, or let the situation happen.
Okay.
So you're bracing yourself.
Okay.
Yes.
I see where you're going with this.
Because at times, like, there have been times I haven't thought about shit.
No, and
just
it just
get
happens,
one out
right?
of nowhere. Like,
yes.
I'd be in class, man, sitting there.
Wait. But class, is it ever truly random? Because, okay, for example.
Yes.
Yeah.
This past Thursday, right?
Okay, tell me what happened.
I was early. I was sitting in class.
Okay.
I was having a very normal sexual day.
Gotcha.
Nothing fancy.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Okay.
I mean,
we'll delve back into that later on. But go ahead.
Okay. And then back to back.
Gotcha.
The three most attractive women walk in.
Okay.
You got
Names omitted.
Oh,
call
man.
Them random names.
Random names?
We'll call them Lucy,
okay.
Stacy,
Roxanne.
Okay, Lucy is the face.
Okay.
Roxanne is
tits.
The lower body.
Gotcha.
And then who is the last one?
Stacy. How are you going to forget their names? How rude.
Stacy, she's just the full package, right?
Gotcha.
So you have face, then the ass, then the full package walk in, right?
Okay, Lucy, mm-hmm. Stacy, Roxanne, full package.
And... I went from, yo, I'm going to actually read this book, I'm going to get ahead, to the entire class,
nobody
I cannot
reads.
Concentrate.
Nobody reads.
And then the fact that they're presenting, and two of those females are in the same group, and I don't understand how people can control themselves. And that's what I mean by prepared, meaning you're putting a set of plans in to try to control yourself, and it never helps.
You want to know my plan?
Sure.
What's your plan?
Tell me.
Immediately think about grannies and dead kitties.
Nah. See, that doesn't
that
work.
That will kill
that
it.
That doesn't work.
That will kill it. Nah, you got to think about a hideous-ass grandma.
Okay.
It doesn't work.
But does that work if they're straight in front of you?
That's what I'm saying.
Where
is your mind truly stronger than your body? Because your eyes can see what's there, and you have to have your mind trick it. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Saying, oh, no, don't look at that. Don't look at that. Look the other way.
See, I've seen some traumatic-looking older people, so I pretty much get an image then and there.
Yeah, I understand.
Continue.
Keep going.
Oh,
Don't worry. Just keep it flowing.
Well,
flowing.
Pretty much, man, in situations, I had realized that I had been overacting. And pretty much nobody had intention on staring at my pants, so I ain't have shit to worry about, really.
That's also very true. A lot of the times when that happens, no one's looking at it.
Yeah, it's a panic because it's something you can't prepare for. Unless you break your dick, then
don't do it.
Do you think
guys.
People aren't looking when you're in private or public? Because
if you're in private, nobody's looking because you're in private.
Yeah, and in
just
public, I mean,
just fuck
a
you,
guy's
bro.
A
fuck
guy's
you.
Pants they bunch up a lot anyway.
It's true. So. They do look bunchy. What would you say?
Bunchy.
I got you. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Pretty much. What about you, Jordan? How do you...
Living the dream.
Nope.
Living the dream. What's up? What's up, bud?
Okay, now, I mean, how would you... Well, I mean, what is your take on this?
On what exactly? Random boners? How to prevent random boners? How to accept death? What do you need to know?
Did we even talk about what do you do after you get the boner? We've just been talking about what causes the boner.
Dude, it's simple. You hide it until it is no longer there.
Okay.
No. Hold up. Let's go back to this again. We went through this earlier, ladies and gentlemen. Francis is not of the norm. Not even close. I'm not of the norm, but I'm somewhat there, as is Michael.
What?
So let me ask Francis.
What does that mean?
Francis, what do you do? How do you accept the situation now that you have a random boner? What do you do?
Okay. How are you putting this on me?
Because what you said, the normal thing somebody would do. What would someone normal in that situation do?
Normal. I feel like this is a trick question.
No. I'm asking you.
What do I think a normal person
would
do?
A normal person. Not you, but a normal person.
Do they know about the flexing muscle technique?
I don't know about
flexing
it.
The thigh muscles. So most of the blood that's flowing into your penis.
Okay,
so,
see, I didn't know about that.
Yes,
so I'm going to say no, a normal person does not know about that.
Well, as you can see, I've had a lot of boner problems.
It's true. So you're not normal.
Well, that doesn't really bother me much. Now, what I want to ask is a regular sexual day with Francis, what does that mean, dude?
Okay, so wait, do they know or don't know about the muscle technique?
They either do or they don't.
I don't think they do.
You know
what,
let's just say this simple. Francis, what would you do in that situation?
Where are we? Is it a few people, classroom, we're in the mall? What?
Okay. You're in the classroom. Go with the situation you described. The three girls walk in. You're in the classroom. What do you do?
I had to grab my dick.
Uh huh.
And I was holding it.
Uh huh. For what purpose?
Yeah,
elaborate. Because
you might lose it.
I need to know.
It felt like he was. I just named it a he. It was losing control, so I had to bring it in.
like it had a mind of its own.
Yes.
So yeah,
wait, so you're telling me when you guys don't get a boner, you don't touch it?
It depends, man. Because most of
I don't pop them in class.
Like by
what I'm saying.
You never got a boner in class.
But okay, I'm saying right? I haven't had that in years because okay. I haven't been to class. In
okay, what about at work?
No,
work?
I've never done it.
You've never had a boner?
Bruh, I've been so busy and tired of everyone's shit.
With all those nurses?
Yeah. Oh, trust me. I love my nurses. They know that. If you're watching, you're probably not, but you know.
However, that was too loud.
They are gorgeous people. And honestly, I've never popped a boner.
Okay, so this is... Okay, Have you ever gotten... This is the horny stage I was talking about earlier.
Okay, I got you. I'm listening.
You never had that sensation coming to where, okay, it's about to come if I don't do something?
No.
What is wrong with
Dude,
you?
Dude, it's simple. As soon as I see it, I appreciate the beauty, and then I walk away from it.
My first reaction when I get a boner, man.
Uh-huh.
I feel like it's a fucking lance popping out. So first thing I do, I push that shit right down on the side of my fucking thigh, and I just I try to chill out. I try to think about what to do next.
Right?
My question, yeah. Right? You guys push it down. Have you ever done the scoop up?
Or did you put it in the waistband?
He knew what it was immediately.
I mean, dude, you know what classic I got that from.
Just wondering.
The scoop always the necessary thing when you're standing up, though?
Yeah. If you're sitting down, you don't really need to do it.
No, that's where you just push it to the side.
But like I said, I've never been sitting down in a random spot where I just go, hey, yo.
No. But that's what I'm saying. Normally, when I get... Okay, when I'm sitting down,
okay.
That's normally the horny stage because I can always control it.
Okay. I think I see what you're saying.
Because I can always... That's where I probably touch myself the most, because I could play around with it, and then that kind of gives off the blood.
Yeah, okay.
But it's the standing that's the awkward part. When you're walking down the hallway, and within 2 minutes, it's bam, 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 mm-hmm. whatever order, breast, mm-hmm. buttocks, lips, yep, gotcha. Whatever it is. Uh-huh. It just, and then what do you do in that moment?
Well,
when
you're my question, right? You're in school, right?
Yes.
Do you not have a book bag or anything? A regular bag? A book?
So what am I going to do? I have the book bag on my back and then I just put it in front?
No, but you have a book bag, right?
Correct.
And in your book bag, you probably have books.
No.
What the fuck is the book bag for?
My lunch.
You carry a book bag for your lunch? Why don't you just carry a lunch bag?
Because I have a lunch box and it has the Lion King.
Okay, we're getting off topic. This man puts lunches in his book bag, but he calls it a book bag and not a lunch bag. I see what
Well, I have pencils and stuff, if that's what you're asking for.
But you don't have a single book.
Do you have
a book?
Oh, yeah, I have a history notebook that's the size of my hand.
What about this?
Brother,
do you have an,
it'll block it.
Do you have an article of clothing in that bag?
Not really.
So you don't have gym?
And yo, don't forget, I ride my bike to school, so I don't want to carry books.
Well, I mean, but you can put them in your book bag.
Oh, shit, we are talking, wow, I thought we were reminiscing on college, on high school, wow.
We could be, but nonetheless, like I said, if you're in school, 90% of the time you have a book of some sort, a textbook, a writing book, anything.
Well,
just use that as the defense, bro. Just... Hold it.
Or you could claim to spot a celebrity and shift everybody's attention, but...
Never works. No one comes to Buffalo.
That's true.
Yep.
That's
sad. Yeah.
Where are we going right now?
Dude,
I feel like we're all over the place.
I'm okay with it.
I feel like it could just branch off anywhere.
We're all over the place, but we're around a certain object. You know what I'm saying? We're like the planets around the sun. We're still there. We haven't left the galaxy. Not yet. But soon.
Okay, so...
Or is that just me?
Yeah, I was hearing it, too.
It's in the background. Like, dum, dum,
dum, dum, dum. It sounded like Jumanji.
It stopped. Okay, it's gone. Never mind. Everyone ignore that.
They have no idea what we're talking about.
I mean, they should probably be able to pick it up if we can.
What are you talking about?
There was thumping in the background. Not anymore. It stopped. But there was there. Francis, you're going crazy now. Michael, you heard it, right?
Yeah, it literally sounded like Jumanji.
It was just like, dum, 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 dum. That's it.
Do you hear static?
But it was probably the train going by.
I do hear a little bit of static.
Bro, this is going to fucking piss me off.
Dude, why? Just deal with it. Just talk over it. If you talk over it, you can hear it.
But is it just us or can they hear it?
If they can, I don't care if they can hear it or not.
But that's ruining the podcast. We're talking about boners and then all of a sudden they hear static.
Okay, first of all, it's not like a... You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They can. If we're talking over it, they can't hear it either.
Okay.
As long as we keep it flowing, keep it moving, keep it grooving, you know what I'm saying?
Keep it flowing like a boner.
Those don't really flow, do they?
Can you just the blood flow.
I'll do it. What do you want me to do?
That's this how one? They stay this erect.
One? Which one?
This Michael's.
One? Michael's.
Attack.
There you go. How's that?
Holy shit.
That makes a difference, right?
Does it?
That eliminated the static, too.
You're welcome. Don't say I never did nothing for you.
Okay, so now we just know.
Yeah.
Just adjust it to where they were, where we had them preset. So if they're already there, then we're good.
Everyone's is good.
Okay.
Except for mine. There you go.
Okay. All right. Well, this is our first this is our first episode. We apologize for that.
Dude,
but
don't apologize to them. Apologize to me.
Whoa. You should be apologizing since you put it up a tad bit too much.
But remember that note you wrote.
You know what it was really about? I wanted to say it on the slide. Move this up a tad because it's a tad bit low.
Oh, no. Yeah, I already knew that. But that's okay. I don't care.
Yeah.
But anyways.
Well, that was for nothing.
I am not going to apologize because I'm an amateur. I'm not a professional.
We're working out the
We're working it out. So talk to me. Talk to me. But don't yell at me.
What the way I feel about it.
Yes, Michael. Let me know.
Okay, wait.
I don't mind.
What are we on? What are we on? What are we on again?
Okay, let's go down the line.
What line?
The average...
Coke line?
The average amount of times you think you get horny in a day.
Okay, that's too much.
The amount
much.
Of level... How many times that horniness leads to...
Hold on. Yo, let's just go. Isn't there like a fact where we think about sex like 6 times a minute or something like that?
Like, bro, do you want a real number or something fictitious?
A real number.
It's not going to happen. It's too much.
Because I could definitely give you a fictitious one right now.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I'll tell you how much. Too damn much. That's how much.
I think mine is so much, I start counting with ABCs.
Okay.
That makes no sense to me, but I'm okay with it. It's so much, I just start doing my ABCs. I don't understand. I mean, I don't understand, but you know, I can't judge you, but I'm just saying. It makes no fucking sense.
I can't even process a word right now. Okay, what qualifies as horniness? It has to last at least 15 seconds.
Oh, then I would actually put the number smaller than that. Because there are certain moments where you're just like, for a split second, you go, and then it's gone. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. What would that, is that truly horniness or
that's
a
why
temptation?
I said, because you said 15 seconds, so I wouldn't qualify.
I would say
that temptation.
I would more
temptation
so.
Temptation real quick. And then it's gone.
Either that magic. Or just a typical spike in hormones.
Yeah. I also, yeah. We are guys. You got to think about it. Like I said, 90% of the time, what's on our mind? You already know.
Yes, sir.
It's just how it is. That's just the way we
it's
were wired.
More than 90. That's
just how the way we were wired.
That's what we agree to, though.
Okay. To make it easy, how many times in an hour would you say that?
How many times in an hour?
Yeah, like on average, if you're in a regular public setting.
If I'm in a public setting, I would say not a lot. Maybe once or twice.
Yeah, I'd say about once or twice.
If I'm alone and I know I'm alone, it pops up more often. You know what I'm saying?
It does?
To me, it does. I have a boundary set between public and private.
That's your thing.
That's
why.
That's
that
it.
Explains it.
Boundaries, bro. You got to have them.
No. I understand the at home because at home,
you're
I would
home.
Assume we all feed the geese.
I don't know what that means. I don't know what that means. I'm a Christian. I'm a born again virgin. Don't let nobody know that, though.
Oh, God.
Yep.
Okay. Are you innocent now, too?
I've never been innocent a day in my life.
So you're just a virgin?
I'm a born-again virgin.
Okay.
I respect that to its entirety.
Thank you.
Oh, God.
No, thank you.
You're welcome.
Just go down
but
the line.
I mean, like...
Just a guess.
In a normal...
Oh,
in a
public
normal...
I would say like 2-3 times, easy. But still, that's
in about
that's
an hour,
amount.
Right?
Yeah, that's a small amount still, though.
How many times... Does that lead to actual hard-ons?
Not often. If I'm in public, not often at all. I would say zero times. I have not caught one in public in a very long time.
Yo, now thinking about it, I...
Yeah. It just doesn't happen anymore.
Wait, what doesn't happen?
The actual boners.
It happens a lot when you're younger because that's your hormones flaring up.
But no, but at home, I get boners all the time.
That's because you have a boundary, like normal people.
But I don't have a boundary.
You do, but you don't know it's there.
Do I,
Jordan? You have not broken
it yet. All the toes I've told you. Yes, I really?
But you have a boundary. See, you just admitted it. It's an unconscious boundary. You don't, because you just said it happens more when you're at home. Because it's your body saying, oh, you're at home.
No, but what I'm saying is I think it's less at home because I don't care. You remember how I said the precautions when I'm in public, I'm always touching myself?
You got to stop doing that, bro.
I think that's why it doesn't lead to the next level. When I'm at home, I just let it happen. And then once it happens, that's what leads to the feeding the geese, you know?
I don't know.
Can we adopt a different way of saying that?
Feeding the geese.
Like, I'd rather you say spank the monkey or something.
Does chucking the wood count?
No. I'm a born again virgin.
There was another one. What was it? Chucking the shaving the carrot? You want to use that one?
Carrot. Who the fuck?
I've never heard of that before.
Yeah, you shave the carrot.
No, she just say beat the meat.
I wouldn't want to think of a knife in my member.
No, it's not a knife. It's like that thing where you shave the yeah. But what does a shaver do?
It takes shaves. Off skin.
No, but what's the motion of a shaver?
It shaves, bro. That's all you need to know. It shaves.
What's the motion?
It don't matter. Motion. It's not about the size of the wave.
It could go diagonal. It could go.
But the motion of the ocean. Circular. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so beating the meat?
Nah, that's too okay.
Okay, so feed the geese.
Feed the geese, baby. What is a geese technically, though?
Okay, we're getting off topic
not
again.
A gander.
Gander beneath my frock.
This is gonna be a live editing.
But did you know a geese? All right, that's a female. Is a a goose is a female geese, and a gander is a male geese. Did you know that?
That makes so much sense now.
Yeah, because what's good for the goose is good for the gander, is what's good for the girl is good for the guy.
Are you being serious right now?
Yeah.
Oh, I seen a episode of Family Guy when he went to the like medieval era, whatever. Anyway, she said, take a gander beneath my frock. He grabbed a fucking... he grabbed a goose and shoved it under her dress.
See? So a male...
I believe it's a male geese is a gander, and a female geese is called the goose. It's either that or it's the other way around.
Is a geese just the
geese
species?
Is the plural? Is the species the plural? Yeah, never knew that, did you?
No.
Yeah, just something to think about while we were talking about feed. Just because feeding the geese, you know, I want to get it correct.
Yeah.
Feeding the gander maybe, or feeding the goose.
Okay, since we're on this topic. Nah, never mind. That's never mind. Another.
Erase it.
You could say you
rewind.
I was going to
lead in to something more.
The feeding the geese topic.
Feeding the geese. That's going to have to wait till next time, ladies and gentlemen. We don't talk about feeding.
But is that everything?
Public boners. Don't do it. That's all I got to say.
But okay, we still haven't answered a question.
What was the question?
What happens when it does happen? Worst case scenario.
Put me in a situation.
You're in the mall.
Paint me a picture.
You're walking down.
Walking down the mall.
You've already had a horny day.
I'm standing up.
Yes.
Okay.
Standing up.
Gotcha.
And then you're walking past three women. That just sets you off.
Okay.
But.
Okay.
You're about to meet. You're coming up to your girlfriend. And okay. You guys have a date.
Okay.
What do you do?
Okay. I do a scoop up. And I walk away.
You do a scoop up. Are you doing that while you're walking towards her? Are you looking around? Are you seeing if anybody's looking?
I get into a corner and I do the scoop up.
You get into a corner?
Yeah. It's a mall. There's got to be a corner somewhere. Or I go to the bathroom.
No. There's no bathroom. There's no corner. It's a straight alley.
This is bullshit. We're in a mall. Are we not in a mall?
You said, and I'm approaching my girlfriend.
Yes. Are you going
to
be the guy?
Ask her to do the scoop up. I don't know.
But are you going to be the guy who bullshits and if she notices and you say, oh, baby, it's because of you?
I mean, if it came down to it, yeah. I'd be like, oh, look what you did to me out in public. You're hard.
No, I'm just fucking kidding. I have a bad habit of being very truthful, even if it has an effect.
I'm the opposite. I have a bad habit of lying a lot. I do. I know it. I tell people I'm a liar all the time. They don't believe me. I'm a liar. It's just because it's more fun, and I realize it makes me a bad person, but I'm okay with it.
But you were upfront about it.
That's what I'm saying.
So are you really a liar?
Exactly. You see my problem. People don't believe me.
Man, that is so fucking complex.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you see why people don't understand me. It's because I tell them I'm a liar. I give them the truth, but then later on, I sprinkle lies everywhere. It's like a minefield of lies.
Did you see how he said it?
I'm just saying. It's just how it is, man.
I think I go with the lie, though.
Lie?
I wouldn't want to get my dick yanked off.
No? No. I'd probably lie, too. But if I was in a mall that had no bathrooms and no corners right. for me to do the scoop up, then I would have to go with a lie as well.
Okay, are we missing the biggest thing?
What's the biggest thing?
At least us. Do we care? Because I've gotten to that point where I'm getting to the point of direction, right?
Okay.
I just put my hand in and I just, if somebody sees it, hey, I got caught. If you like what you see.
Bro, there's children. Women and children.
No, in college. In high school.
Dude, I thought we were in the mall. I right. don't understand, bro. The situation keeps changing. And when the situation changes, my reaction changes. I don't understand.
No. I'm saying just no matter where you are, do you care?
Yes. If I'm around children, I definitely don't want that.
Right.
Adults, I care less, way less about. But children, I don't need them with that negativity in their lives. Not yet. Wait till they get older.
Why does it matter if it's children?
Because they're still innocent. I right. do not want
to
be the one.
That was the best way to say it.
Okay, but if they're innocent, then what do they probably think you have a big Jolly Rancher or whatever in your...
That's what makes it creepy, bro. Nope. That's what makes the person that has that boner feel awkward. Because
why you got a boner around a kid?
A kid will believe, like, damn near anything, you know?
But do we know this kid? Because if we don't know the kid...
But dude, it doesn't matter. It's a kid, bro. It's a kid. Why are you popping a stiff near a kid in the first place? You understand the problem? That is already in itself a big problem.
Yeah.
Okay. I understand it's not because of the kid, but near the kid is a no-no. That 100% you will get arrested. 100%.
What? No.
Want to bet?
Yes.
Go pop a stiff near a kid right now, Francis. I'll see you in 10 to 15. I'll see you in 10 to 15.
We'll see.
I can't control my what?
We'll see. It don't news matter, for 10 to 15 minutes.
I understand if the guy starts choking the kid with this hard on.
Nope.
Okay, so just no stiffy near.
No stiffies near kids ever. God damn it.
Ever.
That's exact. Yeah.
I think it's overblown.
I mean, you're not normal.
If you know yourself, then what's the problem?
You're right. If you, as long as you,
this is where I think it's an American thing. Francis. So for example, kids go to naked beaches. What's up with that?
But no one, you know, it's not. You're not supposed to pop stiffies at naked beaches. Did you know that?
Oh, okay, but a kid could look at a bare penis, some bare breasts, but the moment you pop a stiffy,
yes, because that is a sexual intention. That's what that is.
So if a sexy ass mom walks around and she turns me on, oh, I have to control my penis.
You ever heard the saying?
No. This is the thing though. It seems wrong to me in Jordan. It doesn't mean necessarily that you know it's the right or wrong thing because things happen for the moment. We can't control shit.
But I'm just saying, bro. Public will see you as
they'll see you a monster.
Yeah. You understand? That's what I'm trying to say.
I kind of don't give a fuck.
See, you don't care. You will have inner peace while you are locked in a cell. And you can be okay with that, but I'm not. You see what I'm saying? You may not care, but society doesn't give a fuck if you care whether or not.
I'm
you know
really
what
pissed off you're hung up on this whole jail time thing.
Bro, because I'm telling you. It's set in
I'm
my mind.
I'm not beating
maybe,
my meat.
Maybe
I'm
it's
not
just
showing
me,
my penis.
But you have a kid that is not good.
Okay, so what if there's a whole bunch of females and then a random kid pops up? That's my fault?
No. But you better that's do something kid's about fault. It.
And if he's interested in the boner, that's a less a pro- that's less my problem and that's more a kid problem.
I'm just
So no, seriously, in that situation, if there's a man, he's at the park sitting down.
Okay.
He's about to kill himself. He's just saying fuck life. Okay. And these three beautiful women pop up.
Okay.
And he's like, God damn. And he just gets a boner. Okay. And then a kid comes up, the kid's in the area. So right from your diagnosis, I'm in the wrong. Mm-hmm. And then if the kid comes closer and is interested,
hold on.
I'm even more in the wrong.
First of all, you're in the wrong because you don't care. A normal person would care. Remember, that's how this started. You did not care that you had a boner in front of a kid. Anyone else would have been hiding that boner with their life. With their life.
I'm not saying I'm not hiding the boner because I don't want the females to see, but...
But you said you didn't care, so you would just let
I'm saying I don't care if I have a boner in front of a kid if he pops up.
You see? But I'm saying... Oh, see, battery low. I'm saying... That I care. Oh shit, we might have a problem there. No.
Oh.